day to you all, and welcome to the Methodist Connection. Half an hour of hymns and songs and the stories behind them. Thanks so much for your interest and support. We are delighted that you could join us as we celebrate on this last Sunday of Advent and as we anticipate the Nativity. May you be truly blessed as you share in the singing of the carols and the message presented today. We begin with the well-known Christmas carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. The author is Charles Wesley, who wrote over 6,000 hymn texts. This may have been one of his best. In singing this hymn, we not only join the shepherds under a canopy of singing angels, we also learn about the Jesus they proclaimed. We discover who he is and what his coming means. Wesley's carol is filled with powerful scriptural ideas. A month could be spent exploring these stanzas. But let's focus now on the last four lines. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. These are the reasons why Jesus came, so we would not have to face eternal death. So he could raise us with him, and so he could regenerate us into children of God. For these and so much more, he deserves our praise. Glory to the newborn King. Please join the Methodist chorale and sing, Hark the Herald Angels Sing Glory to the Newborn King. It's numbered 63 in the Methodist hymn book, Voices in Praise. Our next song is entitled early Christmas morning with words and music by one of our well-known sons of Jamaica, Professor Barrington Chevans. We thank him for helping us to express through this song our joy at the coming of Christ the Savior. Fi we God great fi true. Join the Methodist Youth Chorale and sing Fi we God great fi true. We hear next this bright Christmas song, Never a Baby Like Jesus, King Emmanuel, Wonderful Counselor, Never a Baby Like Jesus. The little baby Jesus, born in a manger, Jesus my Lord, he came down to earth as a poor little stranger, Jesus my Lord. Why this positive statement by the songwriter, Never a Baby Like Jesus? Well, for Christians, the Christ child within us is still the answer to our yearnings. But you know, not even God can bring an answer to those who will not recognize their need. If you and I are ready to confess, then we are ready for the fulfillment that only Christ can bring. Jesus is the King of all ages, says the author. And we who accept this truth are invited to kneel down and adore him, Jesus, my Lord. The Spanish Tongue Methodist Youth Ministry Group sings for us, Never a Baby Like Jesus.
Jesus.
Our next hymn is Thou Didst Leave Thy Throne. The hymn reminds us, Thou didst leave thy throne and thy kingly crown when thou camest to earth for me. But in Bethlehem's home was there found no room for thy holy nativity. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus. There is room in my heart for thee. It is number 97 in the Methodist hymn book. Emily Elliott, 1836 to 1879, the author of this hymn, had a special concern for those who were sick. She wrote many poems and hymn texts, especially for the infirm, publishing 48 of them in a book called Under the Pillow. She may have been influenced by her aunt, Charlotte Elliott, who wrote Just As I Am. Charlotte, also a prolific poet, was sickly for much of her life. This hymn was written for children to teach them about Jesus' birth, and it has a simple construction. Each of the first four stanzas presents a contrast, beginning with the word but. Although the world then had no room for the Lord, we can have room today for him in our hearts. And the last stanza provides a stirring conclusion. The Lord, once rejected and displaced, will soon come in victory, and we should all be waiting. The choirs and congregation sing, Thou Didst Leave Thy Throne, and it is numbered 97 in our hymnal, Voices in Praise.
Thank you. that your baby boy will one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know?
The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will lead, the dumb will speak, the praise.
We close with the Magnificat. This is known as Mary's hymn. It is found in the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 1, verses 46 to 55. Verses 1 to 4 say, "My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior, for he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name." Please join the Methodist Youth Chorale and sing along with them Magnificat, "My soul doth magnify the Lord." And the tune is written by Father Richard Holong.
Lord, my God, he is my all.
Thanks so much for joining me on the Methodist Connection. I am George Mulrain, inviting you to join us next week at the same time on this same station for the Methodist Connection. You may write to us or email us with your comments or suggestions for hymns you would like the choirs to sing at Jamaica Methodist Link, 143 Constant Spring Road, Kingston 8. The email address is jamaicamethodist.org. You may also send us WhatsApp messages and voice calls on 876-445-5713 or 876-925-6768. Do continue to support us by joining us each week in viewing these programs and experience God's blessing through song. We invite you too to make your love gifts for the upkeep of this ministry. Please make checks payable to the Jamaica Methodist Link or use one of the contacts on your screen to arrange for electronic transfers or deposits. Do have a very good day. The peace of Christ be with you now and always.